Savard. Savard came in and got Mandage from behind. And this could get pretty ugly here in a hurry. Larmer is going at it now with Freese. Freese will take care of that real quick. Ooh.
Well, I don't know if it made contact with the ice, but I certainly hope not. As Freese picked him up.
And look at this. Here's Fox and Young. I mean, sometimes you talk about two teams who don't like each other, but this is very evident here, and it has over the last couple of years. It's a great rivalry. Unfortunately, sometimes it gets a little out of hand. But Mandich did a good job. Now we have Flett and Secord going at it again. Down at no fight, but they're squaring off and talking to each other.
Well, the linesman gets two North Stars in
with Secord, but at this stage of the game, and here we go again.
This is Ciccarelli and Savard in front of the Minnesota bench. And Frazier joins in. He should be the third man involved in the fight. And now the Chicago bench is emptied. And the two North Stars have just come out of the penalty box.
As he was in a different place right now. Everything's right in front of him.
Well, we've gone through, let's see, 34 Spectrum telecasts, and this is the first outbreak.
Watch Ciccarelli. He's out in the middle of the ice, and he's trying to bait Savard.
He looks like a bull in a ring.
He's trying to bait him.
This situation. Savard has been extremely dangerous all night, and I don't want to underestimate the loss of the Ciccarelli, but he's got a lot of guys behind him to continue in the scoring. As the North Stars, we mentioned earlier, have a very much more balanced scoring attack than Chicago. Well, even from this close-up range, it's a little hard to figure out what's happening down at the bench, because virtually everybody is paired off.
Well, Willie Plett's gone through a lot of dimes dancing with Al Secord for the last 10 minutes.
Nobody seems very eager to break this one up either, and Brian Lewis has the pencil and paper out.
Well, you know, you and I both talked before this game about how physical we expected this thing to be, and it's going on again.
Now Ciccarelli and Higgins, and Brian Bellows gets between them.
Thankfully, incidents like this have been very rare this year. Now Tim Young is in the Chicago bench with Fox.
They were paired off, it seemed, rather harmlessly on the far side of the ice, you'll recall, before this all broke out. And apparently they remain paired off.
Look at Milosh and Batterman at the bottom of your screen. They got the best seat in the house.
Of course, the two backup goaltenders, Beaupre and Esposito, dutifully have remained in their respective goal creases. Now Young wants to get out. And at center ice, here's Bobby Smith and Larmer. Or is that Ludzik?
That's Ludzik.
And Freese has Fox pinned to the board.
At least 10 couples squared off here on the dance floor.
If you can get a wide shot of the ice here on the rink,
it literally looks like prom night at the Met Center.
No doubt. Well, with each ooh and ah from the fans here, we look at a different area because it's almost impossible.
Bandage of some sort over his left eye or over his right eye.
Presumably from the earlier fight, I would guess. Well, it's just a tragedy. I mean, I can see a fighter.
Watch out, watch out.
Ciccarelli and Savard. And will they let him go?
this. This will start everything all over again. They just started to settle down.
Well, Chicago,
some of the fans are getting into it, which isn't going to help.
Chicago, of course, wants at all costs to protect Savard.
Well, I think
by towering over the North Stars bench, he's gesturing either to Ciccarelli or to the linesman Wayne Bonney at center ice. Now Secord puts one of the North Stars down, and I would hazard a guess that it might be Fletch since they were last seen together. Through the bodies, you may get an idea just as soon as we do as to who it is.
It's like Mandich, 32. And I'm looking to see who's out there. I don't see Wilson. He might be.
Ciccarelli and the linesman Bonney are poised just inside the Chicago blue line.
Well, here comes the chant for Dino. Away.
Rather lost Ciccarelli, leaving Kevin Collins with the remaining 40 players on the ice.